The supplement industry is very unregulated. You don't have to have FDA approval to come out with a dietary supplement. That gives people room to come out with some, you know, lower quality products.
This product says new legal formula on it. I don't know what the old what the old formula really had in it. Belizean man vine extract.
I don't want any part of that.
Best if used by date and lot number on bottom of can.
Yep.
I always thought the health industry was about, you know, health. Why does it feel like we're back in the Wild West?
It'll clean your teeth and curl your hair. The best in the West. I wouldn't be dead without a bottle.
Well, we can all thank the senator from Utah, Orrin Hatch.
Look how good he looks. I want to get his brand is what I want to do.
See, the health industry is big business in Utah. They make almost a quarter of all the dietary supplements in America. And supplements are a $24 billion industry. So you do the math. Making supplements used to be like making prescription drugs. You had to prove your product was safe and effective before you could sell it. Well, the supplement cowboys in Utah thought that was a real hassle. So they asked their favorite senator to change the rules around. And now you don't have to prove your product is safe at all. And the FDA has to prove that it's not safe if they want to take it off the market.
What is this red goop?
This is the Canadian version of Redline. We had to take out some of the ingredients that aren't legal in Canada.
Thanks to this deregulation, the supplement industry exploded, and all sorts of new and interesting people got in on the action.
Yeah, we were always a good team, whether we were selling drugs or whether we were selling a supplement like we are now.
Jekyll and Hyde supplements, you know, formulated to awaken your other side. Take this and all of a sudden you become the freak, the monster. Everybody wants to become a monster.
You know, if Valentino can make a supplement, I bet anyone can do it.
Hola. How many guys you need?
I need two guys. We're making dietary supplements, and I just need a hand with a couple of things. It'd be really easy. All I need you guys to do is take the white,
put it inside.
Boom.
First, you buy a bunch of really popular ingredients. But the trick is, I'm just going to use a tiny amount of each one. Oof. It's what we like to call in the supplement biz, pixie dusting. See, I can hide my secret formula behind the term proprietary blend. And not reveal that it's pretty much just a pill full of rice flour.
This is a good way to make a lot of money. Don't sneeze in the supplements here.
But with all those expensive ingredients on the label, I can make this bottle for about $1.40 and sell it for $60. Thanks, Orrin.
We're in the supplement business now.
The scary part is that everything I just did is by the book. Well, except for the illegal immigrant day laborers. But hey, nobody's regulating them either. Now I just need a misleading advertisement.
They airbrush these guys a lot when you put them in magazines?
Definitely. There's all kinds of techniques and tools you can use to completely manipulate the body.
Really?
In fact, I mean, some of the before and after pictures, they could be done in the same day.
You haven't shot them in the same day, though, have you?
I have, actually.
Oh, you have?
Yeah.
What do they do?
Is this the self-editing part? I should keep my mouth shut?
I could take anybody and take a picture of them. Make them look their worst.
Think horrible thoughts, depression.
And then through all kinds of ways, make them look their best.
Just don't cut my nipple off.
All right, let me see here. Good, 1, 2, 3. Good. We can take it a step further if we want. In the befores and the afters, basically you can take somebody and make them a little fatter or shorter.
Are people falling for this?
They fall for it all the time, and it's beyond what I can understand because it looks so silly to me. But of course, I'm somebody who's had sort of an inside backstage pass of what's really occurred, and I've been part of some of these scams that have played out.
So if unregulated dietary supplements are marketed like steroids and sold by people who are on steroids, is it any wonder that so many people are just taking the real thing?